Another feature of Java is it's multi-threaded. All right? Now, you might hear the term called multitasking. We also have the term multi-threading. All right? Now, let me explain a little bit more what's the difference between multi-threading and multitasking is. Now, in Windows, when you press Alt Tab, you're switching from one application to the other. For Mac, if you press Command Tab, you're switching from one application to another. All right? That's in Mac. Now, when we talk about multi-threading, it's actually the behavior of an entire application that can process several threads. Now, what are threads? These are small processes that can perform concurrently, all at the same time. For example, if you're using MS Word or MS Excel, or in my case, MS PowerPoint, I can edit my PowerPoint, edit my presentation as I print some of my presentations. And as I'm printing my presentation and I'm editing them, I can also save some of my additional features or additional slides. So saving, printing, and editing, all done in my PowerPoint, in my single application PowerPoint, that is what we meant by multi-threading. Multiple processes can be done in the same application concurrently. Now, can you think of other types of applications that are multi-threaded? If you're thinking about games, then you're correct. Most games right now, especially the video games, are multi-threaded. So for example, if one character is doing one thing, another character, let's say, is doing another thing, and there's a sound playing at the background, then there are already multiple processes that are concurrently running. The task that you're doing, the enemy that's doing something, and the background that is playing the background music or even the background backdrop, the graphics at the background, they're all running concurrently. So most games are also multi-threaded. Now, let me show you a sample code on multi-threading. Okay. So this is a sample code. Let me just open this. Now, I mentioned that this is not really a small chunk of code. Okay. So just like to mention the owner of this code, this was the author is K. Horstman, all right? And this is a code that he wrote for his book, and I'm going to reuse it. So this one, let me open my terminal window, okay? And let me show you what a single threaded application looks like. So we will compare two things, single threading and multi-threading. Okay, so let me compile it first, Java C. I'll compile everything. All right, so in my code, I have a class called Bounce. And let me see. All right. Okay, so here's an application, a GUI application, all right? So this is a frame. When I click on the start button, it should release a bouncing ball. Now that bouncing ball will exist for 3 seconds, all right? Based on the speed and as it hits one of the side of the frame, it will end at a certain location. So if I resize my frame and I click start, it will end on a different location. Okay, now this is an application that shows a single threaded program. Why single threaded? Because this one can only process one process at a time. So if I click the start button 5 times, click, 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 you'll see that there's only one bouncing ball released at a time. Okay, because this is what we call a single-threaded program. All right? Okay, I'm still waiting for the balls to finish bouncing all around. All right, we're done. Now, allow me to show you a different version of this same application. Let me close this one. And let me move on to another folder called multi-threaded program. So let's compile this. And let me run this bounce thread. Okay. So this time, this is the multi-threaded version of this bouncing ball application. So same program. If I click on the start button, you'll see a bouncing thread launch on your app, on your frame. So if I click this 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you'll see that there's a bouncing ball that is released every time I click on the start button. Okay? So if you want, if you decided to do a rapid click, 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 and then you decided to resize the frame. There we go. Resize the frame again. So there we go. So every time you click, a small process will be spawned, a small process will be created that represents the bouncing ball. That small process is what we call thread. And every time you click, there are several threads that are spawned, that are created. So this is a version of Java that is called multi-threaded program. The first version that we've seen earlier is single-threaded. This one is called multi-threaded. All right? So let me go back right here. One of the key features in Java is it can create both a single-threaded program and a multi-threaded program, which makes it perfect to create games, to create web applications, because, you know, games can be played by multiple players, right? Just like the bouncing ball that you've seen earlier, there can be multiple processes running within the same frame. Now, for games, you can also, for games, it can also be played on an Android application or even in a desktop application or even in a web-based application. That's why Java is so perfect to be used for web applications as well. In fact, later in the next couple of slides, we will take a look at the three different Java platforms. Is there a platform that we can use for desktop? There's a platform that we can use for mobile apps and for web apps.
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps and also read some great articles on their blog page.